10,000 kilometers apart in two completely different worlds, two outstanding runners. Kip Keino, the first in a prestigious series of Kenyan runners. And Jim Ryan, the gifted American schoolboy. Two careers and two competing styles that will repeatedly come face to face with each other between the years of 1967 and 1972, a rivalry that will push both athletes to the extreme.
These are the leading teams, the third runners, getting ready to hand it off to the anchor runners. Kansas fans will recognize Paulie Gruber, a sophomore in the middle, waiting for the handoff from his teammate Hodges. And he's got it, and he's ready to try to take it. And that is good. We've got four laps between those two runners.
The story begins in Lawrence, Kansas, in the heart of the United States. Memorial Stadium is Kansas University's sports stadium, which boasts one of the country's best athletics teams. It's here where almost 40 years ago, a young high school student first started attracting attention. In 1962, Jim Ryan, then aged 15, met the man who would change the course of his life. The man is Bob Timmons, the athletics team coach at Wichita East High School, where Jim is still just one student amongst many. Not particularly standing out, in fact, probably slightly less gifted than the others.
As a seventh grader, he tried to sprint, wasn't fast enough. And in the eighth grade, he tried to run hurdles and was too awkward. And his balance wasn't very good. And so he didn't make it there. And then in the ninth grade, he ran the longest race you could run, which was a quarter of a mile. He was a little bit too slow for that to even make a relay. So that's the way it all started.
But the young Ryan didn't lose heart. He was determined to join a school sports team, but the question was, which one?
Thanks very much, I appreciate that. Hey, Jim, how are you?
Good, it's good
nice to see
you.
You. How are you?
Hey there, man.
Yeah, you did. Nice to see you.
As an incoming sophomore into a three-year school, you were required to attend an orientation assembly, at which time they would talk about the school's history, the education system, and then the sports system. And I remember Coach Timmons standing up, and you really, I was way back in the back of the auditorium, and you could barely see him because the podium pretty much blocked him off. He was a man of small stature, and yet dynamic in the sense of being able to motivate athletes. And he talked about a sport called cross country. And I decided, since I wasn't making any other athletic team, why not try cross country? So out I went for the cross country team in the fall of 1962. I had no idea what it was all about. And if I had known ahead of time, I might not have done it.
The Eldoret region in northwest Kenya. Here in the heart of the high plateau that dominates this part of East Africa, the altitude is above 2,000 meters. Eldoret is the epicenter for Kenyan athletics. It all began at the beginning of the 1960s with the emergence of one of the first Kenyan athletes of international stature, Kip Keino. Kip, now 62, still lives here. in the place where he was born. He was the first African world record holder in both the 3,000 and the 5,000 meters. The great Kenyan athletics school flourished in the wake of his success, and today it's rare to set foot in the Eldoret area without running into an athlete, either just back from a competition or training for one.
When you go beyond that side there, we had some runners. Mm-hmm. We had some world-class runners who have represented this country in the, mm-hmm. in the Olympic and also the Commonwealth Games World mm-hmm. Championship. 3,000 meters, 10,000 meters, and 5,000 meters runners mm-hmm. ran from this end. Two couples won the family, a man and a woman, they won the mm-hmm. medals in the last Olympic, the Atlanta Olympic Games. There we have the 3,000, which I was telling you, 3,000 meters Cebu, Peter Koech. So he's also my nephew. Yeah.
Well, but how come there are so many in the same little area?
Well, it's interest. They like to run and they are following what I was doing. So a lot of encouragement.
But is there a natural gift or something in this area?
I can't tell you because I don't know.
What do you think?
I think it's a lot of things. It's interest, hard work, and a lot of determination.
I used to look after the goats, ships, and so forth. And we live in a normal African life. Well, those days, the parents of the children, they value more of looking after their own animals, cows, and so forth, than education. Education was not very important. When I wanted to go to school, my father says, you have to look after the animals and so forth. It was very important for me to go to school. But I could not also say no to my dad.
At the same time that Jim Ryan joined his school's cross-country running team over in Kansas, Kip, 7 years his senior, joined the Kenyan police force. The country was at that time still under British rule. It was the only way he could both work and continue his increasingly demanding training routine.
When we were at home, we used to see film. Before they show any film, first introduction in film is sports. We used to see like Olympic. We used to see people like Jesse Owen, people like Baba Nurmi. Quite a lot of people we used to see, runners from the developed world. I learned from other people. You can see people doing training and you sit down and copy what they are doing. You always sit down and talk. How many miles you put up? He says, well, I think I'm doing 60 or 100 miles a week. How do you put that mileage? You know, you talk. Some they cannot even tell you. And that's all.
Bob Timmons was in the Marine Corps, which gives you kind of a picture of the level of structure that Bob had and the demands that he expected out of the people around him, not only out of himself, but also out of his athletes. From the things that I heard about the middle distance runners, it was not a very friendly workout. It was a very, very difficult workout, sometimes at a level where, you know, some people would quit. But Jim did not quit, and a number of them stayed with Bob through these workouts, and it made them really, really good runners.
Despite still having some problems with his balance, the young Jim Ryan is making progress.
I didn't notice anything for a long while. But then, see, in the spring, in his first meet outdoors on a track running a mile, he was running against a young man by the name of Charlie Harper, who was our state champion. And during this race, what Jim was running with, and I thought to myself, well, Charlie's not as fast as he used to be. But it turned out that Jim was a lot faster than I thought he was.
We exchanged the lead back and forth till we got to the finish line. He, being the more experienced runner, leaned to the finish line and won. And as I'm over on the sidelines after the race, with my hands on my knees, you know, every element of my body hurting, one of my teammates came up to me and said, you know what you just did? And I said, well, I finished second. I was really happy with it. I said, no, you don't understand. You finished second to the state champion at 1 mile, and you ran a 4:32 mile, and that was 18 seconds faster than I'd ever run before.
This was a really great jump. And at that time, I told Jim that I thought he could be the first 4 minute miler. Well, that hadn't entered his mind at all. And he's probably wondering if I'd come from Mars or something saying that. No high schooler had ever run a 4 minute mile. And it wasn't just talk, I really thought he could. And so times kept going down, and by the end of the season, he'd run 4:08, 4:07:08, and it was really obvious that here was a great talent. And then from there, he was invited to Compton 2 weeks later. And this was a very knowledgeable group, a big crowd, a night race on a beautiful track without any Kansas wind. And he'd started out pretty well, and he was in a good position. And then, for whatever the reason, he was pitched forward. He didn't fall down, but then he was losing time, and he had to wait to get back on. And I thought, oh boy. The goal in this race was 3:59 flat, and I thought, there's no chance he's gonna do this now. But he got back in the race, and people ran so fast in trying to catch them that he ended up in eighth place. And then I thought he might have done it, but I wasn't sure. The announcer read all the way down through these times, and when he came to the eighth place time, and eighth place is Jim Ryan from Wichita East High School at 3:59 flat, which was exactly his goal. And I realized then that wasn't the end.
In Kenya, at the instigation of the British government, regional then national competitions are being organized. At the police academy, Kip is soon spotted by the new head of sports activities, John Belzian. Belzian had previously been coaching in England and specialized in long distance running, and it was his expert eye that recognized the potential of Kip Keino.
We had a small meeting in a college one afternoon on a grass track. And along came this young man, and the first thing that really impressed me was the length of his legs. He seemed to be all legs. And I went and stood next to him for a moment. He's a little bit taller than I am, not a great deal, but he is taller than I am. But his hip was sitting up here.